Hello dear children, good afternoon everyone, and once again welcome back you all to the online classes. And today we are going to discuss about the sixth unit. Already we have discussed the first chapter from this universe, that is the sixth unit of your science part. And today we are going to begin the second chapter, that is Earth and the Moon. So in the first chapter we have learned about the stars, planets and the earth, and in our today's class we are going to discuss about the earth and the moon. So first, before going to learn about this, just we can recall what we have learned in our previous classes, so later on we can discuss about the earth and the moon. Okay, so here the stars. So we know that what are stars. So stars are the luminous heavenly bodies, because they emit their own light and heat. And our nearest star is the sun, and the distance of the sun and the earth is around 150 million kilometers. And also we have learned about our solar system. It is having 8 planets. They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So these are the 8 planets, and Sun is at the center, and all the planets are revolving around the Sun in an imaginary path called orbit. And these Earth are there in the fixed path, that is due to the gravitational force of the Sun. Right? So this is all what we have learned, and also we have learned about the Earth, the different layers of the Earth, as well as the other objects also we have learned what are they. So now in this class we are going to discuss about the Earth and the Moon. So we all know that the common thing, that is the Earth, only the life exists on the Earth. So other than that, there is no life on other planets. Only the Earth is having the planet, and that is due to the different criteria. So that to sustain life, they need some different basic needs are there, like water, air, and also the soil. Yes, the sunlight, that too the proper amount of sunlight. So if the temperature is exceeds, so that we cannot survive. So some planets are there, they are getting more sunlight, so that we can call the Venus as the hottest planet, right? So it is having the temperature about 400 degrees Celsius. Can we able to survive in that 400 degrees Celsius? So when the water is boiling, its temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. Yes, can we able to touch the boiling water? No, we are not able to touch. But in that Venus, it is more than 400 degrees Celsius. So in that temperature, can the life is able to exist? No, it is not possible. So since the Earth is having all the basic needs in the optimum amount, in the proper amount, the life can exist only in the Earth. And the Moon is the natural satellite. It is the only natural satellite of the Earth. And Moon is the third planet in the solar system. And it is called as blue planet because the 3/4 of the Earth's surface, it is made with the water. It contains the water. And when we observe it from the space, it looks like blue in color. That is the reflection. So when the water, it reflects the light, so it looks like blue in color. So that we call the Earth as the blue planet, and it is having the only one natural satellite, that is the Moon. And the Earth is revolve around the Sun, as we all know that the Earth as well as all other planets, they are all revolving around the Sun. And it is revolving from the west to the east. So the Earth, it revolves east and it is sets in the west, because the earth is revolving in the direction west to east, so that it seems opposite to us. Okay, so this is what about this recall, or we can say the recap about what we have learned in the previous classes. And now I wanted to suggest you an activity to do, that is nothing more. So you no need of any objects to observe this. Just you need a paper and pen. So it is a continuous and slow activity what I am going to suggest you now. Now what you do, so every day the day comes, and after the day the night comes. So just observe the moon in this night sky for 10 days. So the main thing to observe in the moon is its shape and size. What is the shape of the moon every day? You just observe it for 10 days and every day you just observe. Okay, the shape, usually you have to concentrate only on the shape of the moon. So how it go on varying from day 1 to the next day, and you can compare that with the 10th day, or likewise you can observe whole month, so that you can able to understand how the shape go on increasing in the first half and how it go on decreasing in the next half, so that you just able to understand the phases of the moon, right? When the varying in the shape, so that it indicate that they are all the phases of the moon that we are going to discuss in the next classes. Okay. So now we can discuss about the moon. Yes. So now we can start with the moon. What is the moon? The moon is the only natural satellite of the earth. Yes, this is the first thing. The moon is the only natural satellite of the earth. So you have already learned that the different planets are having different number of satellites, the natural satellites. Likewise, the Venus, the Mercury and the Venus, they do not have the moon only. They do not have any natural satellites. And the Mars is having two natural satellites. It means that it is having two moons. And likewise, the largest planet in our solar system, that is Jupiter, it is having 67 moons. And the second largest planet, that is Saturn, it is having 62 moons. And Uranus is having 27 and Neptune is having 14 moons. So likewise, our Earth, it is having only one natural satellite, that is the moon. And the surface of the moon, it is having many craters, plains, mountains and valleys. So after the explanation of this topic, I am going to show you how the surface of the moon and how we can see the rotation and revolution of the moon, everything. I am going to give an attached video clip of the periwinkle so that you can able to understand. So because more than the theoretical explanation, when we come all these, so the videos are help you understand better than the normal explanation. So that after this explanation, I am going to attach a video clip with this so that it will be understood easily. Right? Okay. So the surface of the moon, it contains, so surface of the moon, it contains the craters, many craters are there, the huge ridges, and the plains are there. The plain area is also there, and some mountains are also there on the surface. Yes, as well as the valleys. present on the surface of the moon. So the surface of the moon contains craters, plains, mountains and valleys. That is the reason we are not able to see completely white moon. We are not able to see. Somewhere we can observe some black patches, right? That is because of presence of all these mountains, valleys and all. So the mountains, valleys, because the craters are there, they are the loose ridges. So when it is loose ridges, so that will be appear like the black patch. Yes. So this is what the surface of the moon. And we all know that the earth is revolving around the sun. Meanwhile, the moon is also revolving around the earth. Yes, in the orbit. In the orbit. So think that it is the sun. Okay, this is what the sun. And around the sun, the earth is revolving. The earth, it is revolving around the sun. And the moon is revolving around the earth. The moon. So the sun is at the center and the earth, it is revolving around the sun, and this is the planet and it is revolving around the sun, and earth satellite is moon and this moon is revolving around the earth. Okay, so that likewise the rotation. So we can now discuss about the lunar month and the moon. To complete one revolution around the earth, it takes 27 days to complete one revolution around the earth. The moon takes 27 days. Okay. And now we can discuss about the lunar month. The revolution is different and the lunar month is different. Okay. So now we can discuss the lunar month. So the lunar month is the time taken by the moon to pass through the different phases. Okay, so there are different phases are there, as I said before. The shape is going changing. So the time taken by the moon to pass through a complete cycle of its phases. So I will write the definition. You also take it in your notebook. The time taken, it is the time taken by the moon, time taken by the moon to pass through a complete cycle of its phases. Is called a lunar month. Okay, so the lunar month is the time taken by the moon to pass through a complete cycle, one complete cycle of its phases. So I said that the activity. So every day you just observe the shape of the moon in the sky, so that you can able to find that every day the moon is not in the same shape. So it go on increasing, and next half cycle it go on decreasing. So likewise you can observe the different phases. So it will take place in the half month, the increasing phase, and half month, the decreasing phase. So about that in detail we can discuss in the phases of the moon. So likewise, there are the different phases of the moon. So when to complete the different phases, when it passes through the complete cycle of its phases, that we can call the time taken to complete the cycle of all the phases, the time taken by the moon, that is called the lunar month. So usually the lunar month, so suppose if it is the earth, so the moon will be revolving around the earth. that day, on a new moon day, we are not able to see the moon in the sky. So that we can call as the new moon. And here in some places we can see only the half moon. Okay, and also here different phases are there. In detail we can discuss it in the next classes. So when we are discussing about the phases of the moon, that time we can discuss in detail. And this is what the full moon. So that we can able to see the complete moon. Okay, so that we can call as the full moon. So see the new moon and the full moon, and here they are the half moons. So we can see the half and the complete the lunar month, that is calculated by the cycle from one new moon to the next new moon. So from one new moon to the next new moon, this is called a lunar month.
Okay.
So see how it shows the variation. So see, from near to near the distance is less. Yes, no? And here the moon is farthest. Yes, in this position, the position of the moon is it is farthest from the sun, from the earth, and it is, we can say it is farthest and it is nearest, or we can say the close. Okay, it is closest distance. So when the moon is moving here in this path, it shows the slow movement. It is very slow when it is moving in this path, when it is farthest from the earth. But when it comes near, then it shows the fast movement. And again, when it reaches the farthest, again it slows down its movement. And when it reaches the closest, again it speeds up its movement. So likewise, the moon, it shows the variation in its speed when it is revolving around the earth. When it is closest, it fastly it moves, and when it is farthest, it will move slowly. So likewise, it will revolve around the earth. And since the moon is also rotate as well as it revolves, but the time of rotation, because its rotation is very slow, so that the time of rotation and the time of revolution, it is approximately equal, so that we can see the moon, because the positions, we cannot much differ in the position, so that we can able to see in the same position. Okay, this is what about the moon. Now, I will give you an attached video clip with this. Now, let me show that. Surface of the moon. Moon, the earth's only natural satellite, and it has craters, plains, mountains and valleys in its surface. Scientists believe these were formed around 3.5 to 4.5 billion years ago. The moon revolves around the earth, completing one revolution in about 27 days. Lunar month. The time taken by the moon to pass through a complete cycle of its phases is called a lunar month. You can see the different phases here. A lunar month is measured from one new moon to the next. The duration of a lunar month is about 29.5 days. As the moon orbits the earth too constantly revolves around the sun. The moon therefore travels a little more than a full round from one new moon night to the next. So you can see here, a lunar month is longer by approximately 2.5 days. Moments of the moon. Moon orbits in an anti-clockwise direction, that is from west to east. The moon travels in an elliptical orbit around the earth and at different speeds in a single revolution. It moves the slowest when it is farthest from the earth, and fastest when it comes closest to the earth. So this is how it shows the movement. The time taken by the moon to complete a full rotation on its axis is nearly equal to the time it takes to complete one revolution around the earth. So this is what the movement of the moon.